Dear students, Namaste, good morning to you all, and also welcome to another session of our mathematics class. In the previous session, we have discussed question number 1 to 5 from exercise 7.1. Hope you have revised well. In today's session, we shall discuss the remaining questions from exercise 7.1 and also will discuss exercise 7.2. Let's move on to the topic. Before starting the session, let's recall the four congruency criterions. The first one is SSS criteria for congruency. It says three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Here S stands for side. The second criterion is SAS criteria for congruency. It says two sides and the included angle of one triangle are respectively equal to two sides and included angle of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Here S stands for side and A stands for angle, and the angle is included between the sides, means angle is in between the sides. That's why it is called the included angle. The third one is ASA criteria for congruency. Here A stands for angle, S stands for side. It says two angles and the included side of one triangle are respectively equal to two angles and the included side of another triangle, then we can say that the two triangles are congruent. Here the side is included between the angles, so it is called included side. And the last one is RHS criteria for congruency. Here R for right angle and H for hypotenuse and S stands for side, and it is exclusively for right angle triangles. It says hypotenuse and a side of one triangle are respectively equal to the hypotenuse and a side of another right triangle, then we can say that the two right triangles are congruent. And here H stands for hypotenuse. We know how to identify the hypotenuse. It is the longest side of a right angle triangle and it is opposite to 90 degree. Next, we shall discuss some properties of triangles. A triangle in which two sides are equal is called an isosceles triangle. This we have already learned in the smaller classes. Isosceles triangle means two sides must be equal. Here, triangle ABC is given to you. The length of AB and the length of side AC are equal, that is 3.5 cm, and BC is having another length, that is 5 cm. When you observe triangle ABC, here two sides AB and AC are equal in length, that is 3.5 cm each. Therefore, we can say that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle with AB equal to AC. Two sides are equal. Next property is angles opposite to equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. This is a very important property. Angles opposite to equal sides. Here there are two sides AB and AC. Here when you check AB, the opposite angle is C, and when you check AC, the opposite angle is B. Means these two angles are equal. Angles opposite to equal sides. Here AB and AC are equal sides. Angle opposite to AB is C. Angle opposite to AC is B. So here angle B is equal to angle C. The next one is the sides opposite to equal angles of a triangle are equal. The reverse statement of the previous one. The sides opposite to equal angles of a triangle are equal. Here triangle ABC is given to you and two angles are marked, that is angle B and angle C. Angle B is equal to 50 degree and angle C is also 50 degree. So angle B is equal to angle C. The sides opposite to equal angles means here C, if you take the side opposite to C is AB, and if you consider B, the side opposite to B is AC. Means here AB and AC are equal. So AC is equal to AB. Each angle of an equilateral triangle is of 60 degree. This also we have learned before. each angle of an equilateral triangle is of 60 degree. Equilateral triangle means all three sides are equal. Three sides equal means three angles also must be equal. And three angles equal in the sense, by using angle sum property, the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degree. So if you divide 180 with the three angles equally, means each angle will get 60. So 60 into 3 is 180. So each angle of an equilateral triangle is of 60 degree. Hope it is clear. Next, we shall discuss question number 6. The question is, in the given figure, AC equal to AE, AB equal to AD, and angle BAD equal to angle EAC. Show that BC is equal to DE. There is a diagram given to you, and in this diagram, all these given conditions are marked. Like AB and AD are equal. It is marked with the single cuttings here. AB equal to AD. And again, double marking if you check, that is AE and AC. That is mentioned here, AC is equal to AE. And here, arcs, if you check, angle markings, that is angle BAD marked with a single arc. And the same arc is marked here also in angle EAC. That means these two angles also equal, which is given to us. So it is given that angle BAD equal to angle EAC. That is from here we have written. And when you closely observe this diagram, angle BAD close to this angle, there is an angle CAD. And again, when you check EAC close to this EAC, the same angle, that is DAC is there. Means DAC is in between these two angles. That is angle BAD and angle EAC, the given two angles. In between these two given angles, there is an angle here DAC. So what we are going to do is, we just add that angle DAC in this equation. That is angle BAD, that is here angle BAD plus angle DAC is equal to, here on the right side angle EAC is there, that we have written angle EAC plus the same angle DAC. So we added angle DAC on both the sides. There is no change in the value because angle DAC is added on both the sides. Means the same quantity is added on both the sides, then the equation will not be changed, it will be balanced. Then where angle BAD and angle DAC together, if you take, when you look at the diagram, angle BAD and angle DAC, means these two portions together, if you take, we will get as angle BAC, BAC. And angle EAC and angle DAC, if you take together, angle EAC and angle DAC, if you take together, we will get angle DAE. You can check here, DAE. So this one we have calculated and kept here, and we will use it in future calculations. So let's take in triangle BAC and DAE, because we need to prove BC and DE equal. Means if you check the diagram, BC is here and DE is here, DE. So we have to take two triangles including these two sides, that is BC and DE. BC and DE included sides are, triangles are BAC and DAE. So we have taken triangle BAC and DAE. So when you look at the diagram, it is quite clear that angle BAC and angle DAE, if you consider, AB and AD are equal. Look at this diagram, AB on the green portion and AD on the red portion. They are equal. Reason is, it is given to us. Next one is angle BAC is equal to angle DAE, that we have proved before, and we are going to use this one for this congruency purpose. So that is proved above. Then AC is equal to AE. When you look at the green portion, double marking, that is AC, and the red portion, double marking, that is AE. So AC is equal to AE, that is also given to us. Now two sides and the angle, they are equal. So by SAS congruency rule, we can say that triangle BAC is congruent to triangle DAE. So the two triangles are congruent. Once these two triangles are congruent, directly we can write BC and DE, because as I said before, BC and DE are the parts of these two triangles, and we have proved these two triangles are congruent. So these two parts will be equal by using CPCT condition. So BC is equal to DE by CPCT. Next, move on to question number 7. The question is, AB is a line segment and P is its midpoint. D and E are points on the same side of AB such that angle BAD is equal to angle ABE and angle EPA is equal to angle DPB. Show that there are two sub questions. The first question, we have to prove triangle DAP is congruent to triangle EBP, and the second question, we have to show AD is equal to BE. First of all, I would like to tell you that this question you will do it as homework, but I will explain the procedure. So you must listen to the procedure carefully and you must do it independently. So the question is, the diagram is here and the given conditions are marked. Angle BAD and angle ABE are equal. So when you look at the diagram, angle BAD, it is marked with a single arc, and angle ABE, when you look at the diagram, it is ABE. This is also marked with a single arc. So these two angles are equal. And angle EPA is equal to angle DPB. So EPA, double arc is there, and DPB, DPB, this also marked with a double arc, means these two angles are equal. And one more condition is given, AB is a line segment and P is its midpoint. So that is not marked in the diagram, you have to mark it. AB is a line segment and P is the midpoint, in the sense AP is equal to PB, that you have to mark with a single cuttings here on both AP and PB. Then we have to prove that triangle DAP is congruent to triangle EBP. First of all, let's check that triangle DAP, DAP, this triangle, obtuse triangle, and EBP, EBP is here, EB. I am not highlighting this one because in the examination point of view, highlighting is not possible. So you must go through the diagram by your own eye and your own mental calculation. You must do it without highlighting it. So you must practice that. So because of that, I am not highlighting this question. The triangles I am not highlighting. So the two triangles we have taken, DAP, DAP, and another one is EBP. And when you look at the given conditions, one angle is there here, this angle is there on the second triangle, they are equal. And AP and PB, two side also is there, they are also equal. But there must be one more angle or one more side that we have to calculate, or we have to make it by using the given conditions. Just like the previous question, when you check angle APD, if you consider angle APE is given to us with a double marking, and it means that is equal to angle DPB, and in these two angles there is a common portion, that is here, that is EPD, just like the previous question. So what you supposed to do is, here angle EPA and angle DPB you have to take, EPA and angle DPB, DPB, this one you have to take, this equation, and we have to add EPB, EPD on both the sides, left side also, right side also, you have to add EPD. So the left side become EPA plus EPD. So EPA plus EPD, if you add these two, you will get this angle, that is angle DAP. Similarly, the same way on the right side, if you check, you will get angle EPB. So we will get this angle APD is equal to angle EPB. So two angles and the included sides are equal. Two angles and the included side equal means by using ASA congruency condition, we can prove that these two triangles are congruent. So by using CPCT, we can prove this AD and BE also equal. So this question, you will try it as homework. Next, move on to question number 8. The question is, In right triangle ABC, right angled at C, M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. C is joined to M and produced to a point D such that DM is equal to CM. Point D is joined to point B. Show that the first question, triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. Second question, angle DBC is a right angle. Third question, triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. And the fourth question, CM is equal to half of AB. So there are four questions we have to prove, but these four questions are all easy questions because once you proved triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD, by using that congruency, we can prove the remaining questions. The diagram is given to you. First of all, we have to prove this triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD. So let's take this triangle AMC and triangle BMD and let's highlight it this one. So triangle AMC, AMC and triangle BMD. So by using the given conditions, we can write AM is equal to BM. Here it is there, AM. AM is equal to BM. It is given to you in the question, M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. So if you take AB, M is the midpoint. So AM, AM is the red portion which is on the part of triangle ACM, and BM, that is the green portion, and it is the part of triangle BMD. So AM is equal to BM because M is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB that is given to us. So we will write M is the midpoint of AB. Second condition, angle AMC is equal to angle BMD. So you can check here angle AMC and BMD. In the previous class, I have explained to you there is an X formation angle. When you look at this AB and CD, and when you join AB and CD, it looks like English alphabet X. And there is an angle here, that is angle AMC, that is this angle, and another angle is BMD, that is this angle. So these two angles are called vertically opposite angle. So they are equal, vertically opposite angles are equal. And the next one is CM is equal to DM. Here it is given to you, CM is equal to DM. That is given to you. So C is joined to M and produced to a point D such that DM is equal to CM. That is given to us. So by using that given condition, we have written CM is equal to DM. That is given. Now these two triangles are congruent. Triangle AMC is congruent to triangle BMD by SAS congruent rule. Two side and the included angle are equal. So the first part is over. And the second part we have to prove angle ABC is a right angle. For that, first of all, we have to write angle ACM. So angle DBC is a right angle. DBC in the sense DBC, this angle we have to prove it is 90 degree. So angle ACM and angle BDM are equal. ACM and BDM are equal because they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles AMC and BMD. Therefore, we can say that DB parallel to AC. When you look at these angles, angle ACM, ACM, it's here. And the second angle is angle BDM, BDM, it's here. So when you combine these two angles, it looks like starting from B, going to D and coming back to C and going to A. Means there is an English alphabet Z. So Z formation angles are called alternate interior angles. We have already learned in the previous class. Alternate interior angles are equal when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal. These are the two parallel lines. This is first line and this is second line. And it is cut by another line that is called a transversal. Then these interior angles are equal. We are using the opposite of that. Here, interior angles equal means these two lines are parallel. Means these two angles, green portion marked angles are equal means the lines which we are drawing is parallel. So DB parallel to AC, reason is alternate interior angles are equal. Then Next, we have learned in the smaller classes about co-interior angles. Means there are two parallel lines. You can see here arrows, same direction, so they are parallel, cut by a transversal. This red line is called a transversal. Then there are four angles are forming. That is A, B, C, and D. And you can see here blue portion, that is violet portion, that is A and B. A and B are on the same side of this line, on the upper side of the line, red line, and C and D are on the down side of the red line. So this A and B are called co-interior angles, C and D also called co-interior angles. So the sum of these angles A plus B is equal to 180 degree. Same way C plus D also 180 degree. This we have studied in smaller classes. So sum of co-interior angles is 180 degree or supplementary. So angle DBC plus angle ACB, you can check here DBC plus angle ACB equal to 180 degree because they are co-interior angles. How they are co-interior angles? In the sense, we have proved BD and AC are parallel. Here it is. BD or DB and AC are parallel. So two parallel lines are cut by another line. So here BD and AC are two parallel lines and cut by BC. So on top of BC there are two angles. One is angle DBC, another angle is ACB on top of BC, these two angles. So they are called co-interior angles. So co-interior angle sum is 180 degree. Then angle DBC plus 90 degree. Angle ACB, we know that ACB is 90 degree because here it is mentioned, hypotenuse AB is mentioned. So AB is the hypotenuse, means hypotenuse opposite angle will be always 90 degree. That is angle ACB is 90 degree. So angle ACB we replaced and put 90 degree. Then we can write angle DBC is equal to this 90, we can bring to the right side. So 180 minus 90, that is equal to 90. So this is what we have to prove. Angle DBC is a right angle. So we have proved angle DBC is equal to 90 degree, which is a right angle. Next, in part 3, we have to take triangle DBC and triangle ACB. Let's highlight these two by using different color. So we have highlighted DBC by using yellow color and ACB we highlighted by using blue color, and there is a common portion for both, that it is BC. Here DB is equal to AC. DB and AC are equal because the two triangles AMC and BMT were congruent. AMC and BMD were congruent, we have proved before. So they are the corresponding parts. This DB and AC. DB and AC are the corresponding parts of these two triangles. Because of that, they are equal. Next one, angle DBC is equal to angle ACB. Here DBC, we have already proved in the previous question, this is 90 degree. And it is given to us AB is the hypotenuse. AB is the hypotenuse in the sense opposite of AB, that is angle C. That angle will be 90 degree. So both angle B and angle C are 90 degree. So they are equal. Angle DBC is equal to angle ACB. Reason is each 90 degree. Next one, BC is equal to CB. So BC is equal to CB, we are writing just for the sake of proving the congruency, because corresponding parts we have to take. That's why BC and CB we have written. Of course, it is BC equal to BC only because the side BC is common for both the triangles, that is triangle DBC and triangle ACB. So BC equal to BC only, but for the sake of congruency, we are writing BC is equal to CB here. Even if you write BC, it's not a problem. Then triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB by using SIS congruence rule. Two sides and the included angle are equal. So triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. Then we have to go for fourth option, that is triangle DBC is congruent to triangle ACB. We have already proved this one. Then AB is equal to CD, or AB is equal to DC. We can write here AB is this one, that is the hypotenuse, and another one is CD, that is the hypotenuse of the LO triangle. By CPCT we can write, since these two triangles are congruent. Here you can see A and B, and here you can see D and C. So AB and DC are equal. By using CPCT we can write, just I am multiplying 1 by 2 on both sides. So 1 by 2 AB, if I multiply 1 by 2 with AB, I will get 1 by 2 AB. If I multiply 1 by 2 into DC, I will get 1 by 2 into DC. Then this 1 by 2 into AB is equal to half of DC. Here DC is there, half of DC is CM. So we have to write half of DC as CM. Then just we have to reverse it, that's all. CM is equal to half of AB. This is the statement we have to prove. CM is equal to half of AB. Next, we shall discuss questions from exercise 7.2. First question, in an isosceles triangle ABC with AB is equal to AC, the bisectors of angle B and angle C intersect each other at O. Join A to O. Show that, first question, OB equal to OC. Second question, AO bisects angle A. Here there is no diagram is given to us. First of all, we have to go through the given conditions and we have to draw the diagram. So before just coming into the diagram, let me explain what it is given to you in the question. There is an isosceles triangle. We know that isosceles triangle means two sides equal. The equal sides are AB and AC. And here there are two bisectors are there. Angle B and angle C, we are using two bisectors, and these two bisectors intersect each other at O. Bisector, we know that bisector means a line segment which divides the given angle into two equal pieces. That is called angle bisector. Here angle B and angle C are bisected by using different line segments, and they are meeting at O, and we have to join A to O. So the figure goes this way. ABC is an isosceles triangle. AB and AC are equal, and bisector from B is meeting at O, and bisector from C also meeting at O. That means the bisectors of angle B and angle C intersect at O, and from O we are joining to A by using a line segment OA. This is the given diagram, or this is the diagram which we are drawing by using the given conditions. Here it is given that triangle ABC, AB equal to AC, AB and AC are equal, and let's highlight these two equal sides by using different color. And here AB and AC are equal in the sense we have learned in the properties of triangles portion, the sides, the angles opposite to equal sides, the angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So here equal sides in the sense AB and AC are equal means angle opposite to equal sides. There is a side AB, if you take angle opposite to AB is angle C. And if you take AC, the side AC, if you take the angle opposite to AC is angle B. That is, we can write angle ACB equal to angle ABC. Angle ACB equal to angle ABC. The reason is angles opposite to equal sides of a triangle are equal. Here, those equal angles we have marked with the red arcs. Next, just I multiplied 1 by 2 in this first equation. This we have done in the previous question also. 1 by 2 into ACB, that is 1 by 2 ACB. 1 by 2 into ABC, that is 1 by 2 into angle ABC. 1 by 2 into ACB. Here ACB is there, total angle, and OC is the bisector. OC is the bisector in the sense whenever OC comes into this angle C, it is dividing into two equal pieces. The upper portion and the down portion are equal. It is marked with a single arc. So half of ACB, we can write it as OCB. OCB. Same way, half of ABC, we can write it as angle OBC. OBC. Therefore, we can write OB is equal to OC by using the previous condition. Means two angles equal here. Two angles equal in the sense sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Sides opposite to equal angles are equal. See, for example, angle OCB. OCB. OCB, if you take, this is the angle. And the side opposite to this angle is this one. The side opposite to this angle is this one. That is OB. That is written here OB. And if you take OBC angle, that is OBC. This is the angle. And if you take this angle, the side opposite to this angle is this one. The side opposite to this angle is OC. So OB and OC are equal. The reason is sides opposite to equal angles of a triangle are equal. In the second portion, triangle OAB and triangle OAC, we have to take triangle OAB and triangle OAC. I have used different colors to highlight these two triangles. And AO is equal to OA, that is a common side. AO and AO are common for both the triangles. So AO is equal to OA. That is common. Then AB equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. That is given to us in the first line itself. AB equal to AC because it is an isosceles triangle. Then OB equal to OC. OB equal to OC. We have already proved here. OB equal to OC. That is proved above. So by using SSS congruency, we can say that triangle OAB and triangle OAC. OAB and OAC are congruent. Then, if these two triangles are congruent in the sense, by using CPCT, we can write angle BAO. BAO, that is this angle, angle BAO, and angle CAO, that is here, this angle. So, these two angles are equal by using CPCT. If angle BAO and angle CAO are equal in the sense, the line segment AO is dividing this angle A into two equal pieces because we have proved this portion and this portion are equal. So line segment OA is dividing the total angle A into two equal pieces like angle BAO and angle CAO. Therefore, we can say that AO, the line segment AO, bisects angle A. Bisects angle A in the sense equally dividing angle A. Hope it is clear. Next, we shall discuss question number 2. The question is, in triangle ABC, AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Show that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB equal to AC. So there is a triangle ABC is given to us and AD, the perpendicular bisector of BC, also given. Here we have to show ABC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle in the sense two sides equal. The equal sides must be AB and AC. This is what we have to prove. Here in triangle ADC and triangle ADB, there are two triangles available here, ADC and another one is ADB. So let's highlight these two triangles by using different color. In triangle ADC and triangle ADB, AD equal to AD. That is a quite familiar to us, common portion, easy to identify. So AD is equal to AD, it is mentioned here, that is common portion. Next is angle ADC. ADC is equal to angle ADB. Reason, each 90 degree, because AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Perpendicular in the sense, here it is marked already 90 degree at D. The angle at D is 90 degree. So angle ADC equal to angle ADB is 90 degree. Next, CD equal to BD. CD and BD are equal. Again, by using the given condition only, that is, AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC. Bisector of BC. Bisector we have already learned, equal division. So, AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC in the sense D is the midpoint of BC. That means CD and BD are equal in length, that is mentioned here. That is reason you can write AD is the perpendicular bisector of BC, or simply we can write given. Therefore, triangle ADC is congruent to triangle ADB by using SIS congruence rule. Two sides and the included angle. Here two sides, first side is this one, second side is this one, and the included angle is here, 90 degree angle. So they are congruent, therefore we can write AB equal to AC. AB and AC are equal because they are the congruent part of the corresponding part of the congruent triangles. By using that property, we can write AB is equal to AC. So two sides are equal, AB and AC are equal. Therefore, we can say that ABC is an isosceles triangle. Next, we shall discuss question number 3. The question is, ABC is an isosceles triangle in which altitudes BE and CF are drawn to equal sides AC and AB respectively. Show that these altitudes are equal. So here the given conditions are, one isosceles triangle is given, the equal sides are AC and AB, and two altitudes are drawn. Altitudes in the sense line segment drawn from the side of a triangle to the opposite vertex, that is called the altitudes. So here two altitudes are drawn, BE and CF, from AC and AB. So we have to prove that BE and CF are equal. So the figure goes this way. ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB and AC are equal, and we have to prove the altitude EB will be equal to the altitude CF. Here, to prove this B and CF are equal in the sense, we have to take two triangles which contains the sides BE and CF. Two triangles which carries BE and CF as the sides. So the first triangle we can take it as AFC. There CF is the side. Another triangle we can take AEB. There BE is the side. So if you prove these two triangles are congruent, then by using CPCT we can prove that BE and CF are equal. It is quite simple to prove the congruency. In triangle AEB and triangle AFC, angle A is common for both. So angle A equal to angle A, that is equal to common reason. Then we can say that angle AEB is equal to angle AFC, both are 90 degree. It is given to us because they are the altitude, or else it is marked here 90 degree. Next, AB is equal to AC. It is given to us. They are equal sides of an isosceles triangle. So by using AAS criterion, we can say that these two triangles are congruent because two angles and one side equal. So by using AAS criterion, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. Since these two triangles are congruent, by using CPCT, we can prove that BE and CF are equal. So this question, you will try it as homework. Next, we shall discuss question number 5. The question is, ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangles on the same base BC. Show that angle ABD equal to angle ACD. Here there is a diagram given to you. ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangles. ABC and DBC are two isosceles triangles. Isosceles triangle in the sense two sides are equal. Here in upper triangle, that is ABC, there are two sides marked with a single cut, that is AB and AC, they are equal. And in the bottom triangle, that is triangle BCD or DBC, there is two sides marked with a double cut, that is BD and CD, They are also equal and they are having a common base BC. Common base BC in the sense this line BC is common for both the triangles, the upper portion triangle and the bottom portion triangle. Both the triangles are having common base BC. Here we have to take the same diagram and we have to draw a construction part, that is we have to join AD. For easy calculation purpose we are just drawing an additional line there, that is AD. That is the construction part, join AD. Then in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, in triangle ABD and triangle ACD, we have to take separately and we have to prove that they are congruent. So AB equal to AC. AB and AC are equal. Reason is given to us because here it is marked with a single cut, so they are equal. Next one is BD equal to CD. BD and CD are equal. That is also reason given to us. Then AD equal to AD. Here AD we have drawn here additionally. That is our construction part. That AD is common for both the triangles. In triangle ABD and in triangle ACD, AD is common. So AD equal to AD. That is a common portion. Then triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD, we can write by using SSS congruence rule. So three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to three sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So two triangles are congruent in the sense these two angles are their corresponding parts. So angle ABD, ABD equal to angle ACD, ACD. They are equal. We can write it by using CPCT. Dear students, in today's session, we have discussed the remaining questions from exercise 7.1 and also we have discussed first 5 questions from exercise 7.2. Hope it is clear for you all, and also I request all the students to go through each and every slide carefully and try to solve all the questions independently, and while solving, if you have any doubt, please write it and keep. We will discuss it during the online session. Thank you for watching.